Bonjour!
Bonjour!
No.
Time for bladder check. Check.
So it's a show?
It's a lifestyle.
It's a religion.
My emotions! My emotions!
I'm still French.
Ouais, c'est pas faux.
I'm a woman, Mary. I can be as contrary as I choose.
Non, moi je crois qu'il faut que vous arrêtiez d'essayer de dire des trucs.
Hello, I'm Laura. I'm gonna watch Stranger Things Season 3, Episode 3. Normally, I made a reaction video just for Episode 1 and 2 together, or maybe a reaction video for each episode. I still don't know what I'm gonna do with Stranger Things because this is the first time that I'm making reaction videos about this show, and I still don't know if I'm reacting a lot during it, enough to make a reaction video for each episode, or maybe for the best moments of 2 episodes, or maybe for the best moments of 4 episodes. I still don't know. I'm watching today 4 episodes, half of the season, of the season 3. So it's gonna be right now the episode 3. The episode 1 and 2 were really great, but like I said during the review of the episode 2, I think that because right now the main characters, the kids, they don't know what is going on, what is happening with Billy, with the rats. Because they are not aware of that, they are really focusing on building the characters, on the evolutions of characters. And that's interesting because kids are not kids anymore, they are teenagers. So to take the time, to take the space needed for them to express what they are now, I mean as characters, as teenagers, you know, they are teenagers, they are building themselves in some way. So for the writers to take time also to build the characters, to, yes, to let them have some space to express themselves, that's interesting, I think, for the show and for the characters. But it's not the usual way of doing things with Stranger Things. During season 1 and season 2, they were going on the same path, characters and storylines, and at the same rhythm. But right now, they are not in the same path. Characters are doing their stuff, living their lives, and the storyline is getting somewhere, but we don't know where. But they are not in the same path anymore, and I cannot wait for them to join each other again, because right now the main storyline about the season is a little behind, you know. We just know a few things about it, but really little things. So we know that this is a threat, but we don't know if it's a big threat or not. So yes, I cannot wait for the two of them to join to know more about that threat, and to have the kids, the teenagers involved in it again. I'm not gonna talk more because, like I said, I don't know what I'm gonna do with those reaction videos, so I don't want to be too long with each introduction and each review. So let's go for episode 3.
Hey, don't worry about it. Okay?
Are they really separate? Okay, they are young, but for me, they are really meant to be with each other. Oh, you're drunk. Yes, you were waiting for Joyce. What are you doing exactly? Oh no, that's dangerous. I don't like that at all. Capturing people. Is he gonna see her? Get out, Levin.
What happened?
Say it. Tell her, please. They don't want to play to that game anymore because they are not kids anymore. Will wants to play. Hangover, my dear. Hangover. Okay, big hangover. And you, where are you? I understand why he's jealous right there, and I understand why he's angry right there, but I also think that what Joyce is saying is important, but really you have to find the good way to express yourself, you know, that's not the good way. She's not there anymore. She's not here anymore.
That would be too much, right, Joyce?
Et voilà! Stupid, you stupid man. Come on! Why don't you quit? Please, just quit, Nancy.
Yeah, exactly. I don't know what a Russian looks like. Tall, blonde, not smiling.
Clichés. Of course, you're not gonna end with her. She's cynical, she's playing with you, you're playing with her, even if it's like. Like that, you know the game.
Oh no, my arm! Lucas, look, my arm!
They are not into that anymore. They grew up. Why am I sad about that? Of course, kids have to grow up, but I like them being teenagers, really. But I'm also sad that. Now they are all about girls, boys, love, playing with relationships. And I'm sad for Will, really, because he has no girlfriend and he's still with that. He was lost for such a long time.
I said forget it, Mike, okay? I'm going home. We're just not in the mood right now. Yeah, Mike.
What?
I'm not trying to be a jerk. Okay?
That was acting like a jerk.
We're never gonna get girlfriends?
Yeah. He lost a part of his life. Of course he is lost. And you're not helping him at all. You're not being good friends with him. And they are not being good friends with each other. I'm on Will's side right there. Really, they don't care about each other. They are not spending time with each other. Okay, they are teenagers now and they are thinking about a lot of things and they are... I'm sad they are not kids anymore. A red door. Yes. 1438. She's alive!
What happened?
Really, Bob? You have to stop that. To stop that because each time that you are remembering Bob, I'm still hoping that he's not dead, but he's dead. We saw him dead, really, really, really dead. So honor him, that's great, but stop playing with my mind. That's not him. Maybe with the initials? Silver Cat, yes. Yes, girl. Can someone just slap him, slap his face? I want to slap him so hard. And you have to quit that job, really. Slap them and quit that job, please. That's sweet.
You have people that know you've been there. You have people that care about you.
People that stop Clark.
That was a bad joke. I'm dying for that ship. Did we lose Will again? I'm tired of losing this kid. I'm tired of being worried about him. He's like me. Yes, you have to say goodbye and I have to say goodbye to that time when you were just kids. That's hard. I loved them so much, kids. I feel your pain. Wait. No! The symbolic of that.
Mrs. Driscoll?
Mrs. Driscoll? Is that you? What? Mrs. Driscoll is... She has a problem. I said it. I called it since episode 1. Jumpscare. Of course, jumpscare. Come on, Hooper. You son of a bitch. What? Where is she?
Where is she?
Where is who?
You know.
Little sorry.
What did you do to her?
I saw your manager.
She's acting like a robot. What happened to her? Oh, I hate you so much. I didn't like him before, but right now I'm hating him more and more. I know he's possessed right now, but he was an asshole before that. Will? Will? Is poisoned them? To possess them also?
I'm really sorry about this guy, but it'll all be over soon.
Yes, they are all gonna be possessed by that thing. That's why I had trouble to connect the end of the episode 1 with the end of the episode 2, because at the end of the episode 1 we saw several persons, aliens, things being a threat, and at the end of the episode 2, just one creature being a threat. Right now, with that end of episode 3, I understand, maybe I'm wrong, but I understand that this thing is possessing people, so that's why during episode 1, they said you have to build what you see. So to build the possessing person's things? Did it make sense? I'm not sure I'm making sense right now. It makes sense in my head, but I'm not sure that I'm expressing myself correctly. Will said he's back. I think that yes, he's back and he's possessing people. Maybe at first he tried to possess rats and maybe there were not enough for him, you know, and that's why they exploded. They were trying to eat, to feed themselves with the fertilizer, with chemical things, to try to survive with that thing possessing them. But maybe they were not enough, and that's why now it's possessing people also, and maybe Billy was the first, and that's why they said you have to build what you see. It means you have to build us, you have to help us to possess people. I'm not sure I'm making sense. I think that you understand what I mean with that, but I'm not sure I'm alright with that because it's logical. I don't have all the information that I need and I'm not even at the half of the season. But for now, this is my theory about the show, about this season 3, about what is happening right there. But you see, what I said at the introduction of this episode 3, I said that for now, they were just building characters, making evolutions for characters, but they were not focused on the main storyline about the season as they wrote the previous seasons. During the previous seasons, they were writing characters and the main storyline at the same level. For the beginning of this season 3, they were more focusing on the character than on the storyline. With this episode 3, it's equal again. That's great. I like that about the show, so I'm glad to have that back. But I'm really feeling like Will, I'm really sad that they are not kids anymore, they are not playing with each other anymore, they are acting each one in their things, they are not... Yes, I'm sad about that. I understand that, of course, they are not kids anymore, they are teenagers, and I love that also because they are exploring new things and I love to see that, but I'm feeling a little melancholic about the two first seasons when we saw them being kids. That was great. And yes, it means that we are not gonna see them being like that anymore. That's logical. That's great also, but I'm feeling a little melancholic about that. I'm not gonna talk more because I'm gonna watch the episode 4 right now. I still don't know if I'm gonna make a reaction video for each episode or for 2 episodes at a time. I will see that during the editing. But right now I'm gonna watch the episode 4. It's gonna be maybe in just 1 second for you or maybe in another day. But it's gonna be in 10 minutes for me. So it's all for the episode 3 for you and for me for now. So bye for now. Bye.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me you built a time machine?
Great.